surf, sun, fun. We're celebrating summer in the Ocean State. The Rhode Show Summer Stars starts now.
And tonight, we're hitting the water.
So grab your swim gear and life jacket.
I have an announcement.
And get ready to have some fun in the sun.
We're scoping out some great activities to enjoy here in the Ocean State.
Little elbows crossed, maybe forearm, palm together.
Hope you're ready. The fun starts now on the Rhode Show Summer Stars.
Welcome, everybody, to the Rhode Show Summer Stars. We are so glad you are joining us as we continue to celebrate everything that's great about the summer season in Rhode Island. And it really has. It has been a great summer season here in Rhode Island.
We have been all over the state checking out beaches, alfresco dining, shopping, family activities, and so much more.
It really has. It's been so great to be able to feature some of the great sights in Rhode Island, some of the great scenes in Rhode Island. We have been very, very busy and really enjoying everything there is to offer here in the great state.
One of the best things that I think we have to offer, and you hear this a lot from people that come in from out of town, is the proximity to the ocean and the water.
Right.
We're so lucky. So tonight is all about on the water.
We don't have to drive very far. Our buddy Brendan, he is really taking advantage of our location today and has been out on the water tonight and is enjoying a great location right here in the Rhode Island.
Let's check in with him now. Hey, Brendan.
Thanks, guys. That's right. We are here at Freedom Boat Club in Warwick talking on the water activities. And let's face it, when you think on the water, you got to think boats.
Just call me Captain Kirby. You ready to hit the high seas? But what are you laughing at? That's not funny at all. I don't know what he's laughing at.
So what is Freedom Boat Club all about?
You make a reservation, you come down, you take the boat out, you come back, our dock hands help you tie it up. We clean it, we maintain it, none of the headaches, but all the fun.
Our first vessel was a 23-foot Tidewater center console.
All right, can I put the motor through the motor thing? All right, what do I do?
Press this button and it'll lift the motor out of the water.
All right. Oh, yes. What can I say, folks? I'm easily amused.
And with that, we were off.
Do I have to go back to work? Can you write me a note?
Here you go. We'll be happy to write you any note you'd like.
That's right. Anything you can
See
do.
If they can take it.
Out on the bay, we let it rip.
Grab hold of something.
Yeah!
If I slipped you $20, would you just jerk the wheel so our cameraman would topple over?
I think that
Love
equipment's worth more than 20.
I think it might be.
Once we'd found a spot, I took care of a special task.
But do you mind before we head back if I just let the people know something?
Let it loose.
Okay.
Let it loose.
Attention patrons of Goddard Park State Beach. Watch the Rhode Show Summer Stars every Thursday, 7 p.m. Fox Providence. They haven't fed me. Get some chowder and clam cakes to the vessel. Stat!
By this point, I may have worn out my welcome.
Is this how most people travel with Freedom Boat Club?
Oh, this is the luxury seat. Just made special for you.
That seems about right.
With that, we headed back to land. And as luck would have it,
lunch on the boat, chowder and clam cakes, it's better.
Nothing.
Nothing.
Could be a little calamari.
A little calamari. Next time. You just pipe down and enjoy.
Right.
Now that I've had my nourishment, yes, we're going to have lots more from Freedom Boat Club as the show rolls on. You guys, we're going to be learning about some different types of boats. You don't want to miss it. Back to you.
Thanks so much, Brenton.
Something that I love to do in the summertime as well, I'm sure a lot of people do, is relax.
Right.
But you know me, I love to work out too.
Yeah.
The best way to combine those two, paddleboard yoga.
Now, I've heard about this before, but what is it really like?
Well, I had a chance to try it out. Take a look.
Yoga itself means union, so it just as it sounds, taking the practice to a floating surface and out into nature.
We've got our boards in the water. Let's go get our yoga on.
Inhale, left ear, left shoulder. Your exhale, chin to chest. And allow the head to rise up to the sky as you open the hands. Let the hands fall down by the rail.
Then things got interesting.
Little elbows crossed, maybe forearm, palm together. Elbows squeeze together. So one more round at your own count, your own union.
Feel like a pretzel.
My favorite thing actually about stand-up paddleboard yoga is it's really confidence building. It makes people, you know, feel good about themselves.
Maybe it's your first downward dog of the day. Maybe it's your first downward dog ever on a paddleboard. Pretty cool.
Then the left foot rises up to the sky, point the toe. Beautiful. Exhale the hands back to prayer. Maybe one more, maybe you want to try to lift up the back knee. And we'll set the knee down.
When you're ready, chest up, thighs up. Beautiful. Lifting up a little bit higher. And everything drops down. We'll keep the hands where they are.
We'll finish the class reconnecting the source with the sound of one ohm. If you'd like to join, inhale through the nose. And just bowing the head in gratitude. Thank you so much for joining today. The light in me honors the light in you. Namaste.
Namaste.
Does it looks really relaxing? I'm sitting here doing this. Oh,
and you know what? You can hear the water just lightly hitting the board.
Sure.
But even that's like a sound machine.
It's
you
really
know?
Nice.
Very, very peaceful. Someone else that is enjoying the water is Brendan. Let's check in with him again.
Thanks, guys. Back here at Freedom Boat Club in Warwick, we've already taken our first voyage. It is time now for our second trip out into the sea, if you will. This time, we checked out a pontoon boat.
It's great to take the family out in. You feel like you're sitting in your living room. Just an all-around fun vessel to be on with your family and friends.
Before we could head out, we just had one small hurdle.
Bill's getting a call. We'll just wait. We'll wait for Bill. It's his agent. He's a popular guy.
The Striper's still out of service, right?
The Striper is still out of service. I'm getting a call, too. Hello? Yeah, Bill's right here.
Okay.
He's on the other line. He owes you how much? $500?
Now we were ready to go.
Get up very close to your screens, ladies and gentlemen. There's nothing more riveting than watching Brendan Kirby apply sunblock to his poorly pigmented skin. I hope those DVRs are rolling. I smell an Emmy, ladies and gentlemen, right there. It's not funny, Bill.
When you're out sea and you pass another vessel, as you wave, let's see if they'll wave back to me.
Yeah! How about you? Guy in the back wants no part of me.
We had once again made our way out. I had yet another announcement to make.
Attention patrons of Goddard Park State Beach, I have an announcement. Will Gilbert's cell phone number is 401.
Just kidding, buddy. I wouldn't do that to you again.
The boat was indeed quite relaxing.
Oh, come on. Can't I just stay out here a little longer?
Yeah, I've been out here almost 3 hours.
Yeah.
Head back.
It's just so relaxing. All right, but we'll head back. Bill, hit it, buddy.
A fun little excursion there with the crew here at Freedom Boat Club. We're going to have much more a little bit later in the show, guys. You don't want to miss my next adventure. For now, back to you.
When it comes to having fun on the water, there are lots of activities to enjoy. And that's where Peter Swain comes in, director of the YMCA's Camp Fuller. Thanks for being here.
Yeah, thanks.
Camp Fuller, right on the water in Wakefield. Great spot, and great spot for sailing.
Absolutely. So we have 300 kids at camp, and on any given day, maybe 160 of them go sailing. So it's small boat sailing. Our kids go to regattas, our best sailors. And so we don't necessarily win, but we hold our own, and our kids love it. So it's really a chance to get them out learning self-confidence, self-esteem, really building skills, and it's a great program.
Yeah, great place. Program. To swim to, and then do things that involve like oars or paddles. You were
lots
mentioning
of paddle sports. Yep.
Yeah, paddle boarding, kayaking, canoeing.
Yep, stand up paddle boards. They've been popular. We bought our first ones like 3 or 4 years ago, and kids have loved them. We do canoeing, kayaking, get kids out on Point Judith Pond all the time doing that. So not as popular as sailing, but still really a great chance to get kids in and on the water.
If you have a few daredevils too, a little water skiing.
Water skiing, yep. So we have two water ski boats that go out, and kids have a great time with that. We do some tubing and some wakeboarding with that as well. So it's really sort of the thrill part of that. And windsurfing also. So we get kids out windsurfing, probably our second most popular activity. And
wow.
There aren't too many camps that actually have windsurfing as a program area. So that's really kind of a unique skill that kids can develop while they're there. So
I like that. Like you said, they're learning a lot while they're having a lot of fun out on the water.
Yeah.
Peter, thank you so much for being here.
Yeah, to get your kids in the water. It's great. It's
Rhode Island. Them in the water and go have some fun.
Right.
Speaking of fun, here are some more events that you can bank on. Check out the 7th Annual Waterfront Reggae Festival this Saturday at India Point Park. You can also enjoy Foo Fest happening at AS220 on Saturday. And it's the last weekend to check out The Wizard of Oz on stage through Saturday at Theater by the Sea. And for the scoop on all of the great events happening in our area all summer long, be sure to download our free app, The Road Show on the Go.
Now, one of the other things that Rhode Island is known for is its rich sailing culture. There is a reason that the sailboat is on our license plate. So I hopped on a beautifully built yacht that was built for the America's Cup to check it out. Heritage was built in 1970 to race in the America's Cup. It never made the race, but has gone on to a great sailing life.
Do you think I could get out there and give this a shot?
You absolutely could. By the time we're done today, well, you'll be fully experienced sailing.
Perfect, let's do this. Oh, I didn't want to be the one to break this thing.
Now that the mainsail is up, we raise the jib to pick up speed. Do I want to drive the ship?
Can't get back there quick enough.
Where we're going right now is you can go kind of in between there's a red buoy and a lighthouse.
Okay.
And we'll go right in between the two.
This is an awesome day. It doesn't get any better than this. It really doesn't.
The Heritage can reach speeds of 12 knots. With the wind we had, we were pushing 11.
It's a whole different experience being on this thing.
Being on the water, on a ship like Heritage, is what living in the ocean state is all about.
So far, do you think we're doing okay?
I think we're doing all right. We're doing great, actually.
No, that's good. That's good. So how do you want it? Just keep it straight?
Straight ahead. You can aim right in the tents off the port out of right now.
Okay. Are you on this some days and just look around and go, can't believe how beautiful it is to be on this?
Most days.
Yeah, I believe it.
You and your friends can charter the Heritage and have one of the most unforgettable days on the water.
We'll come up to the port, and then before we hit the rocks up there, we'll turn.
Oh, we'll turn again, okay. All right,
back the boat, move the sails from one side to the other.
Got it.
I am the captain now.
Ready about?
Okay.
Helmsley.
Helmsley. Now turn the wheel.
Okay, here we go. We got speed.
As our trip comes to a close, it's time to head home.
A crazy day. Like that, we're home.
Still ahead in Summer Stars, we're grilling up some papa squash oysters, the perfect dish for enjoying a night on the water. Stick around as we fire up the grill.
But first,
now we get to be just one of the homes for surfing in the ocean state.
We're getting a lesson. So, can we hang 10 or will it be a wipeout?
And as we head to break, here's a little summer trivia for you. You may know the biggest in the state, like Aquidneck, Block Island, Prudence. But how many islands are actually in Rhode Island? The answer, when we come back,